beautiful people, welcome back. So for today's video, we are going to be doing my month end favorites. And this one, I mean, truthfully, it's more of like a synopsis of the last 2 months, because last month I actually did not put up a month end favorites, and we're going to get into that, why and kind of what's been going on. But before we get into the video, of course, you guys know, I'm going to let you know all the things. Okay, number one, if you are new here, you haven't been around, my name is Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. Thank you. If you've never been here before, you're stopping by. I hope you like it. If you haven't done so yet, please don't forget before you leave to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, because I do upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. They go up around 7:30 a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. Thing number two, and arguably, you guys, arguably the most important thing you will hear in this whole video, the thing that I really hope you take away. If you haven't done so yet, please go down to the description box and follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. They're both linked down below, but the main one, my main cause, my main purpose in life is to get people to come and follow me on Instagram. I have been loving it over there. I've talked about it at length, and this conversation is not going to stop. I do a bunch of IGTV videos for makeup application. I do plus size try-ons, photos for makeup, IGTVs for makeup, just the whole gamut of things. And then in my day-to-day, my, what are those, your Insta stories, I check in with you guys, we talk about stuff, we unbox whatever I get in the mail, and we just hang out. It's just a fun, good time, and I love it, and I'm really trying to get to 10,000 followers so I get the swipe up feature. So if you don't mind, okay, following me on this crusade for followers, please go down to Instagram. At this point, it's just a shameless thing, okay? I do it all the time. It's at the beginning of the video, and you know, it might be considered thirsty, and if that's the case, girl, slurp me up, okay? Because I'm thirsty. I can't believe I just did that out loud. Also, while we're on the topic and acting like that didn't just happen, guess who's drinking her water? This bitch. I mean, I had to drink some water, because truthfully, I think if I don't drink any water, I'm going to shrivel up like a prune here pretty quickly. But look at me. Water. Woohoo. Water. Okay. Let's go ahead and let's get into the video, you guys. Let's jump in to the video. Okay. So first up, as I mentioned before, I haven't done... Do you guys love that I just like lean over like we're talking, like we're all huddled in a little group together? I don't know. I feel like that's weird. Like most people, they're just like, haha, sitting behind a desk. And I'm one of these people. Like, hey guys, how's it going? So I don't know if that's weird or not. If it looks weird on camera, I apologize. But actually, no, I don't, because it's just who I am. But anyways, as I mentioned at the start of the video, okay, I didn't do a favorites last month, and with everything that was going on in my personal life, which, as I mentioned over on Instagram a while ago, if you didn't follow me, a woman who is basically my grandmother passed away, and it was about a month ago, and it really sent my life into turmoil. And then that paired with, there was stuff going on with the shop, and then with everything that's going on with the pandemic, and just, it was literally a perfect storm of absolute hellfire shit that happened in my life all at once. Just with all of that was going on, I was already having a difficult time, like, you know, getting into makeup and really having like any sort, I don't even want to say not having passion, but I was just in like a really weird kind of funky space. Then to complicate matters even worse, okay, it got like really hot really fast. And here in Northern Michigan, which I know some of y'all have clocked me for in the comments, okay, I'm not gonna lie about it. The other day in one of my videos, I said like, oh, you know, it's in the 80s, it's really hot here. And you guys were like, hold my beer, Michigan, because Arizona's like 120. And let me just tell you, okay, at 120, you might as well just get me a damn box and just bury me, because I'm done, okay? Just fuck, I'm done. I do not, okay? My existence was not made for that. Like right now, my thermostat is set to a balmy 60 degrees, okay? I like it cold, I like it chilly, I like to be fully dressed, I like jackets, hoodies, blankets. I like to be like just engulfed in all the comfortable things. So I could not exist in a world where it is that hot. I just can't do it. I will just die. My body, okay? Have you ever seen fat when it melts? Okay, I'll just be a ball on the floor. I'll be a big old puddle of what used to be Page with some bones in there, because I just can't do it, okay? I don't do heat. So on top of everything that was going on, I also then wasn't wearing makeup for like 3 weeks straight. I didn't hardly wear any. I wore a little brow, a little mascara, that was it, because there was no way in hell I could wear any. So I went ahead and this whole long story to say, I went ahead and I skipped my favorites for last month. So what I'm going to be showing you today are just a few products. I really didn't grab much of anything because I've been reaching for a lot of my old favorites just over and over again, but the products I pulled are some that are newer to me, like some things I've been playing with more recently that I really have been enjoying that I think definitely bear repeating. So let me go ahead, and I'm actually going to start off with the non-makeup items first. And the first one is from Wishful, which, for those of you that don't know it, Wishful was released by Huda Beauty, which is Huda Katan. She's also over on Instagram, has a fantastic page. I highly recommend checking it out. I really like her page. But this is from her brand Wishful. This is their Clean Genie Cleansing Butter. And essentially what it is it is a melting setting balm for when you go to remove your makeup. You take some and just, you know, squish it all on there. And which, I mean, if you follow me on Instagram, I use this in an IGTV video. So go check me out on Instagram. But I really, really like this, you guys. The formula is so nice. It's so thin. And I really enjoy the slip that it has. It doesn't take very much at all. Like a tiny, tiny amount will do your whole face. And what I really like about this is because it's so thin, it doesn't leave like any weird buildup. There's no waxy feeling on your skin. It's just so perfectly smooth, wipes away beautifully. I haven't had any issues with it, like no breakouts, nothing like that. And don't get me wrong, as a cleansing balm, are there other options that are more affordable? Yes, there's a lot of them that I really enjoy. There was one that was sent to me in PR from Beautylish, Good Molecules, their in-house brand, and they sent me a tub of theirs. And if you're looking for a really good affordable, like less expensive, I want to say it's maybe $16-ish. I'll have it linked down below. I'll have all of this linked down below if you want to shop anything. But that one's really good. It's more affordable. But if you were wondering about this and you just wanted to check it out, the formula is, I personally really like it. Stuff like this is very individual. You know, what one skin likes, one skin might hate, whatever. But for me, someone who is more acne prone, I have cystic acne, I have scarring, I'm very prone to texture and just all the things. I have not had any issues with this at all. The formula is really nice and I really like it. So I wanted to give it a shout out. And another product, again, not makeup related, I have been using this a ton. Like I'm actually almost out. I have to repurchase it. I'm down to literally what, like 20% left in the bottle. But this is from Briogeo and this is their Don't Despair Repair Strengthening Treatment Oil. And this oil, I just want to give it a shout out because I can't necessarily speak to like, oh, do I think my hair is stronger? Well, like my hair's not lifting weights, okay? Like I don't fucking know if it's stronger or not. But what I can tell you is that this oil, I have been putting it in for, well, I mean, hell, however, when did it come out? Like probably 3-ish months ago or so. And when I use this oil, I noticed that my hair feels so much more hydrated, but it doesn't feel overly oily. Now in terms, obviously, you know, that being said, it is an oil, like it itself is an oil. So you will have that level to it. So I don't recommend putting this in hair that's like freshly cleaned. But for me, I like to take this, like I tend to wash my hair every 2 to 3 days. And on the last day, I always wash or shower, whatever you want to call it. I do it in the morning. So tonight when I go to bed, I'll actually take my hair out and I'll put some of this in my hair. And I coat it pretty liberally from like halfway down and I wrap it up and then I go to bed like that. And then in the morning when I get up, you know, I do my shower and I kind of wash it all out. And what it does, you know, it just gives it that time overnight to really sink into the hair and just really penetrate the follicle as much as possible and just really like nourish it, which is what I'm looking for. And for me, I've just noticed that it's so good. Like I feel like my hair just really enjoys it and it really does drink it up and it helps kind of rehydrate my hair. Now after I've used like dry shampoo for a day or something, or you know, I put it through it, whether it's a bun like this or maybe I used heat products, whatever I do on a day-to-day basis, this really is just a beautiful light refining oil and my hair just seems to really, really enjoy it. Again, I wanted to give it a shout out because like I use a hell of a lot and it's just good. I'm gonna rebuy it. It's fantastic and I really like it. Briogeo is just a great brand in general. If you're looking for hair care, so good. All right, so the next one, we're getting into makeup now and we're gonna talk about the sponge. This is from Kaleidos and I have been obsessed with this. I've used it pretty much exclusively for the last, God, I would say at least 2, maybe even more than that, weeks. And what I like about this, okay, first of all, the texture is great. And you'll notice, by the way, that this is dirty because I just used it to film. Oh, wait, hello, hi. I just filmed this full face. It's testing new drugstore makeup. If you haven't seen it, I'll link it up above. Definitely go check it out. Again, if you are wondering where this came from, it is up there. So go check it out. Now, as far as like what I love about it, the texture-wise here, I think personally, I like this one way more than a Real Techniques sponge. Let me just put that out there. This has more of like I want to say a softer, squishy, like pillowy, like to it. Like when you squeeze it, it just has a better feel. And what I like about it is it doesn't feel nearly as porous, I guess you could say, as the Real Techniques one. So this one just applies my makeup a lot smoother. And then the second thing about this that I like arguably more than the texture is the durability. Because I'm someone, I wash my sponge every single day, okay? I wash it every day. I'm not one of those like, oh, just wet it and go. Because I am more acne prone, I'm super duper careful what I bring into contact, like direct contact with my skin, especially when it's a sponge. For me, every single day, my sponges, they get washed on a bar of soap. I've done it that way for years. And what I have found is that more often than not, after a few washes, I start to see like little spider cracks and little like, you know, areas where the little micro tears, where the sponge starts to break down. And what I love about this sponge is that like, yes, right now, I don't know how well you can see it on camera, but just now, today, when I washed it, I finally started to see a little teeny like micro crack on the surface. Now, I'll still use it because for me, that's not a deal breaker. It's not a super deep crack yet. Anyways, that's pretty much it. I know it's a sponge and that was probably a lot of detail for a sponge, but if you guys don't know me, oh, I'm a sponge bitch, okay? I love me a good sponge. I love talking about them, testing them. I've got a bajillion of them. And this is just like, I don't know, this one really sticks out to me. A great sponge. Now, I don't know if this one, because I was just on the Kaleidos website the other day, and I don't know if these are sold separately or together. I only remember seeing them together, but this one and the other sponge that they released together are $10. So I don't think, I mean, if you break that down, that's $5 for a sponge, and I don't think that that's bad at all. Like, I think it's pretty reasonable, you know, compared to even other drugstore sponges. So for me, I had to give it a shout out. Love the sponge. Oh my God. Okay. We can move on now. Now that I talked about my sponge, we can move on. Okay. So these next two, I don't have to spend a ton of time on because I feel like if you have followed me at all recently, you know that I've been obsessed, but you guys, this Lunar Beauty Moon Prism freaking blush palette is freaking amazing. Everybody's talked about it. I'm not going to go into too much detail again, because it's just at this point, like, talk about beating that dead horse, honey, over and over again. That damn horse is 6 feet under. We're just still beating it to death. And I do not care because this blush palette is absolutely amazing. Full disclosure, this was sent to me in PR, but 100,000% I would purchase this on my own again and again. The quality is amazing. The refinement of these blushes is so beautiful. The texture is fantastic. Fantastic. And when you apply them, if you're like me and you have texture like right through here, it can be a little bit tricky when you're playing with blushes, especially this one up here. There's one, these are all mattes except for this one shade right here. And anytime you play around with a shimmery blush, it can make you like a little apprehensive. But what I love about Manny's formula, what makes it just so beautiful to me, is the fact that these blushes carry with them enough refinement where you get the color, it's beautiful, the shades are fantastic, all of that's great. But the added benefit is the smoothing effect that it has on your skin, the texture, like, it just, you look like the silkiest, sexiest ass bitch at the party, and I just love this so much. I can't say enough good things about it. It's amazing. And for anyone that's been trying to purchase this, I'm not sure when the restock was or if it already happened. Of course, everything I can link, like I said, will be linked down below, but this has been sold out on Sephora and on Manny's website, but I think there's a restock coming soon to Sephora and or his website. So if that's there, again, I'll link it to, hell, even if it's not there, I'll still put the link down below just so you guys can check it out. But it's really good. Highly, highly recommend. There's a reason so many people are raving about it. And I just, if you can get your hands on it, I highly recommend. It's worth every freaking penny. Mwah, chef's kiss, chef's damn kiss, okay? All right, so the next one I have, I don't have to talk about this too much because yet again, if you follow me on Instagram, you will have seen me talk about this a fair amount, use it. I did like a whole little dedicated IGTV video to this palette. I did first use this. I don't know if I mentioned this or not already because I can't remember 30 seconds ago. But I did a full video testing out Danessa Myrick's Beauty. If you haven't seen it, I will link it up here. Truly, like, beautiful formulas. The consistencies, the way that she looks at makeup is just really, really nice. I like it. I like the website. And I kind of talk a lot about it in that video. So definitely check it out if you haven't. But this palette, you guys, even if you're someone like, you work on clients and you're looking for an option that would, you know, span multiple skin tones or multiple preferences, this is definitely your jam because, I mean, truthfully, you have everything you need here. You can mix and match. For me personally, I like to take this shade right here, which is more of a white shade, and I mix it with Piece of Cake or I mix it with Common Sense, so really that top row, just because I'm so fair. And then just to give them a little bit of a swatch, which right now the lighting isn't the greatest, but like, look at, oh, look at me, you don't even need lighting apparently. Look at how beautiful those are. And I like to take them and just mix them together depending on, you know, what I'm going for. If it's more of like a pinky look, if I want to be bronzed, if I want to be whatever, I just take these, mix them all over. And again, if you go look at my Instagram, there's an up close application and they are so beautiful. They have like this pearlized moment going on. They're amazing. All right, so this next product was from, I think it was just like a full face testing new makeup. I'll link it up here if you want to see it, like application and all that kind of stuff. But I picked up the bronzer from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Airbrush Bronzer and I have it in shade 2. And this bronzer, you guys, I feel like this was one of those products that it launched and the world was just like, oh, ah, ew. Like, I don't know what to think. And it was really weird because so many people hated this for the same reason that other people really, really loved it. And for myself, I was really on the fence at first. I was like, oh, you know, I like the texture. I like the application. I like the way it like buffs into the skin. It's a really beautiful mill on the powder. As far as formulation goes, it reminds me a lot of her Airbrush powder, which is really, really nice. And then the weirdest thing happened, okay? After I was done filming the video, you know, my days go on. And during the video, I didn't really form like some crazy opinion like, oh, this is amazing. Or, oh, I absolutely hate it. Absolutely not. You know, whatever. And as the days kept going and after that, you know, day after day, I kept doing my makeup and every single day I kept reaching for the same bronzer. And it was so weird because it took me at least a week week and a half to realize, like, Paige, you have used this same bronzer, and I have other bronzers that I absolutely love sitting right in front of me. Even I had the Fenty Indesun, which this is one of my favorites, and because it's just beautiful. Again, formulation, color, everything about it, I've used this a ton. It's a great bronzer, and that was sitting right in front of me, and I kept, again, over and over, just really reaching for this. And it has taken me this long to just, I guess, come to the conclusion that, guys, I really like this bronzer. I love the tone, I love the texture. And again, at first I was a little bit thrown off, because in terms of pigmentation, God, it is so smooth. Oh, it feels so good. But in terms of the pigmentation, when you go to apply it, it isn't a super, like, harsh, intense look. Like, you can barely see that on my skin right there. It's a very, very light texture, but a very light pigment. So you do build this bronzer up. And for me personally, when I'm looking for a bronzer, that is something I look for. I would prefer a buildable bronzer versus a really intensely pigmented one, because personally, because I'm so fair, I've really got to be able to, you know, work it and build it on my own versus being it, you know, like, straight pigment. By the way, side note, if you are someone, whether you love it or you hate it, I would love to hear from you down in the comments. Like, what is it that you either love or that you hate, especially if you don't like it? Because I'd really love to know, like, from that side of the aisle, what about it don't you love? Because, you know, some people, they don't like that it's light pigmentation. They don't like the texture, whatever. So let me know again down in the comments. What do you think? Do you like it? Do you not? Because this was very polarizing. Very polarizing. Wow. Moving on to my last three products, okay? These all stem from one video. One video we have talked about several times on this channel. Say it with me, because I will be linking, oh yes, testing Samantha Ravindal's favorite makeup. It will be right up here. I highly recommend, if you haven't seen it, go check it out. It is one of my favorite videos. I really, really enjoy it. It's just, oh God, everything about it, like the products I tested, the way everything came out, the application, I just really enjoy it. And for those of you, by the way, that are newer here, you're not familiar, that is a series that I started, and that was actually the first video in it, where I test out another person that does makeup, like, on YouTube. I test out their favorite products and their application techniques, and I go through and tell you guys, you know, not only about the makeup, but why I enjoy them, what I enjoy, and I try to take their things, their style, and kind of adapt them into my own makeup routine and see if it's something that I end up liking. So again, if you haven't checked it out, definitely watch her video. And then I also did, after that, testing Kathleen Light's favorite makeup, which will be listed up in the cards as well. A very good video. I enjoyed filming them both. And because the one from Samantha Ravindal was, like, I think maybe two-ish months ago, maybe even more than that now, but I have three favorites from that video that I have not stopped wearing. And when I tell you, like, I have not stopped, you guys, I can't. They are so good. They're so beautiful. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to start with this one right here. This is probably the one that I was just like, what the hell? Like, out of all the products, okay, if you know me, I am not a corrector kind of lady, all right? I'm just like, oh, look, concealer, poof, fixed it. Foundation, poof, fixed it over there. Like, I don't mess around with color correctors and shit like that. But damn it, Samantha, if you did not just get me, okay? If you didn't get me good with this, the Becca Under Eye Corrector, I have it in light to medium. This is just absolutely fantastic. Like, there's no way around it. In terms of, like, what I imagine when I think of a color corrector, I think of something that is, it's too much, it's overbearing, it never does what it's supposed to do. It gets weird, chunky, it messes with my concealer. And I've had so many bad experiences with color correctors that I never in a million years would have tested this one. So you can imagine my problems, my surprise, my hesitation when I decided to do, you know, testing out Samantha Ravindal's favorite makeup, and it was going to be, like, one of my flagship videos for this new launch that I wanted to do. You can imagine my hesitation when I was like, well, shit, this is what she talks about all the damn time. Like, I have to test it out. And I am so impressed on a day-to-day basis, the difference that this product makes when I just take just a tiny little bit, like what I have on my finger right here, I can tap that out over this whole area. Right here, I just did like a tiny little swatch, but I just wiped off what was on my finger. And you can see there's something about it. It isn't just about, like, addressing the color or concealing or whatever. This has an actual brightness to it. Like, there's like a pulling forward effect where it really does go into this area under my eyes, and it makes them look so much more awake. And it looks like I've slept, which we all know that's not happening. And it has just this way of doing it. And the consistency is so thin, and it sits beautifully under my concealer. And I am so much, this like, out of a lot of the products I've tested lately, this one for me comes so far out of left field. I never thought in a million years I would sit here and say, like, oh, I like a color corrector or a brightener or whatever. What is this? A brightening corrector, whatever you want to call it. This is not the type of product I reach for, even in the slightest. It's so good. I highly recommend it. It's just, oh, it's so efficient. It's great. It's great. It's great. Okay, and now the last two products, guys, we're just gonna talk about it, because these two products, I'm gonna say two products, but really, this one is the star. These are the two eye products I used in that video, and It's not that I ever doubted, okay? I never doubted Little Miss Samantha Ravendahl, but like I have serious reservations and always have about these Charlotte Tilbury eyes to mesmerize things. I've always been like, oh, the consistency, it's kind of a whipped weird situation. Like, nah, it's not for me. Oh my God. Like if you don't ever believe a thing I say, this freaking little pot, this is absolute hot fire magic. Okay. I know you're used to me saying hot fire, shit, trash, garbage. Oh no. This is the opposite of that. I guess I could start by like swatching it. And we can like build on that. But this is the, oh God, everything about, like, I wish when I am not wearing this, I wish I was. Like, that's the level of beautiful. And I've used literally half the pot. Oh my God, it's so good, you guys. The consistency is so light, it's thin, it's airy, it's, oh, and it's so easy to apply, I love it. Anyways, so this is it swatched, okay, right here. Now I know it doesn't look like much, you're probably just like, oh Paige, like it's beautiful, it has like a satin, kind of like a brown, like almost like a pewter undertone, like what's so special? Everything, okay, everything about this is special. From the application, it is so quick. Again, it's light, it's airy on the eyes, but it stays put all day. It's beautiful, it pairs well with other makeup. It just, oh my God, there is, I literally, if I sit here and you were to be like, Paige, you have to name one bad thing about this, I literally don't have one bad thing to say because it's so good. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna stop talking about Little Miss Charlotte Tilbury. I'm gonna put her down for a second because I think at this point I've talked in circles, you know, just like around and around about it. So put her to rest for 1 second and we're gonna talk about this one instead, okay? This is from Hourglass and this was the pair right here that, like I said, I used in that video, the pair that Samantha herself was like, damn, this is beautiful. And I have had this in my collection. This is the Hourglass Scattered Light in the shade Smoke, okay? I've had this in my collection for a long time. I think I have every shade from Hourglass of these. I think they're beautiful. Like, I do love using them, but up until this combo, okay, right here, I have never been someone that like went out of her way to grab them, to use them every single day. And Samantha Ravendahl was the one that said like, oh hey, if you take this shade in Smoke and layer it over this, it's perfection. And oh my God, you guys, it is absolute, like, you, there is no other word. It is perfection. So let me go ahead. I'm just gonna give you, like, this is it by itself. I wanna give you a little swatch of it just so you can see, okay? So there it is on the palm of my hand right there. It's just nice, glimmery, beautiful, shimmery, what have you. And there is the Charlotte Tilbury one by itself, okay? There they are, each separate from each other. Now, let's go ahead and do, like, what I do every single day when I wear it. Take a little bit of the Smoke and we're just gonna ever so nicely, kindly here, layer it in the center of the Charlotte Tilbury one. Oh my God, do you see how beautiful, how it's like they both play off of each other, like the undertone of the Hourglass Smoke shade just ever so beautifully and ever so like delicately, just like, it just like titillates the senses, okay? And what I love about it is it pulls that smoky vibe out of, hell, pun not intended, the name of this one from Hourglass is Smoke, but it pulls that smoky color out of the Charlotte Tilbury, brings it forward and gives you just the most beautiful lilty look on the eyes. Like it literally, when I look at myself when I have this combo on, it looks like I spent so much time, it looks like I cared. And let me tell you, okay, never the case. Actually, you know what, I lied. I'm gonna add on a third favorite because we're gonna add in the brush that I use for this combination right here. This brush, this is the Real Techniques 210 Expert Concealer Brush. And this is a fantastic freaking brush. And you know what, it really should have been in this video anyways, because I went, after I got done filming this video, I had purchased one brush and now I think I own probably three or four of these brushes, because as she said, you know, Samantha Ravendahl talks a lot about this specifically. This brush is so good, whether you want to apply like this right here all over the lids super fast. It has just the right amount of fluff to it, so it blends it out nicely, but it also places it on the lid well. So if you're going for, you know, the packing pressing, you can do it, or if you want to blend out and kind of, you know, smush it out into the crease, make it look nice and blended, nice and airbrushed, you can do that as well, all with one brush. And you guys, in the end, I think what makes this video, this favorite, a little bit more special for me, is that these are the products, like, yes, I only had a few and I went into detail about them, and you know, some people like that, some people don't, it's personal preference and I understand either way. But for me, the reason these are so significant is that these are the products that I have been reaching for time and time and time again over the course of not just one but 2 months at this point. And they're the products that even when I was in a hurry and I didn't have time, even when I was, you know, upset, depressed or sad, whatever, and I didn't even really, like, I was just in a funk, these are the products that like incentivized me to still take the time to do my eye makeup or to care about my complexion or to really like get into it, because in the end, knowing how beautiful they were and knowing what they would look like on my skin, it just made me want to use them that much more. So in the end, yes, there's not a lot in this video, but I hope that you guys liked it, and I hope that you can see the significance in these that I do, because I've reached for them, like I said, time and time again, really been enjoying them. Of course, let me know your guys' thoughts and opinions down below, whether it's on the video, if you still like seeing favorites, if you missed my last month's favorites, or what your favorites are for the month, for the last couple of months, what have you really been gravitating towards? I would love to hear from you down below. Per usual, like I said at the beginning of the video, don't forget to subscribe before you leave, turn on your notifications, and please go follow me over on Instagram, because I'm trying there, guys, I'm trying to build that Instagram platform. I'm trying to make up for the last several years where I didn't bother you about it at all. Well, guess what? Now she's here, she's back, and she's ready to go, okay? So follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. They will both be linked down below. And with that, beautiful people, thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye! Look in the mirror, make sure I look okay. Oh, well, there went that. I love how funny I think I am in my head.